Hey everybody, welcome back. Class notes. Oh.
Listen up now.
I expect your undivided attention, class. Alright, five classes. Scout, Shocks, Lancers, Engineers, and Armored Techs. Scouts are soldiers that excel at reconnaissance, they're mobile at high AP, letting them cover wide areas. Useful for scouting out distant locations and going to the aid of fallen allies. They also have superior detection ability and can sight enemies concealed in grassy areas from farther away. Scouts carry rifles with average attack power and don't have very high HP or defense. Try to avoid direct firefights with the enemy and move your scouts to points of safety. Shock troopers are frontline soldiers that can take out an enemy face to face. They have less mobility than scouts, but the machine guns they wield boast excellent firepower. They have limited range, though, so they need to approach their oncoming fire and get as close to the enemy as possible. This explains their high HP and defense. Their interception fire is also deadly, and they excel at camp defense. Lancers are an anti-armor soldier class. The anti-tank lances they carry do heavy damage to tanks. However, they can only carry 3 rounds of ammo at a time, so they have to be supplied regularly to be effective. They're resistant to explosive attacks with defenses that can stand up to tank fire, but they're weak against infantry. Lancers are unable to perform interception fire, counterattacks, and support fire. Engineers are a support class, proficient at supplying and supporting other troops. They have low attack power and defense and boost unique abilities such as being able to repair tanks with their spanners. They're also able to restock ammunition of friendly soldiers and tanks by simply moving up to them. The ragnade that engineers carry can be used over long distances and replenish a large amount of HP. Armored techs are a special soldier class. They don't carry guns, so they can only attack at close range with their wrenches. However, they always carry shields, which allow them to approach enemies while maintaining a high level of defense. They're also the only class that can repair sandbags and disarm mines. Armored techs are unable to perform interception fire, counterattacks, and support fire. For upcoming missions, you must decide on field placement of squad members during the briefing. Learn the characteristics of each soldier class and consider the best squad composition for attempting each mission. Remember to review that is necessary.
Ah, Avon, how can I help you today?
Alright. Fine for now. Alright. January. Combat exercises. Battle at Landseal Drill Ground. Defeat all enemy units. This exercise will teach you the basic combat techniques, which you learn to kill everybody. Yay! Just kill everybody! Right now we have a bomb. Put Zeri at C. Helmet at B. And Joaquin?
It's showtime, guys! Everybody ready?
Listen up!
Hey, maggots, shut your mouths and open your ears. No mouthing off. Alright. Morale displayed in the upper left of the screen represents the willingness of your squad members to fight. Morale increases as you defeat enemies and capture bases, and decreases when your squad members fall in battle. When morale is high, the positive potential of all allies is more likely to be triggered. Most potentials provide a combat advantage, so try to keep your morale as high as possible. If your morale drops to zero, your squad will decide that they cannot continue fighting and fail the mission. Got it! You better not forget, or you'll be taking a dirt nap.
Okay, let's go! I see one!
Support fire. When a unit attacks, other nearby allies or units may also attack at the same time. It's called support fire. Support fire happens automatically when a unit attacks and friendly units close by. Up to three allied units can provide support fire for an attack. Support fire from squad members that are surrounding compatible will result in a more powerful effect than usual. You can confirm the compatibility between squad members on the status screen. Use support fire effectively to give your squad an advantage in battle. Target my out. Damage also affected by location, headshots also. And somebody's
coming at you.
I'm hiding.
All right. I'm just getting started.
Roger. I'm afraid I cannot allow you to live. I don't miss.
Oh, you can go that way.
Target destroyed.
Leaders. Squads are led by commanders on the battlefield. Avon is the leader of Class G, Rebel Squad leaders of the units wearing red helmets. Squads with leader in the field can have superior command ability and replenish an extra CP at the beginning of the phase. This means when a leader falls in combat, that side will replenish one less CP. If you track down the enemy leader, focus on defeating them first to give you upper hand in the battlefield.
Underway. Enemy sighted. I don't miss.
Okay, let's go! Enemy down!
Still.
Moving out. Moving out! You're through! Enemy sight!
Alright! We got the target!
I thought there would be more dudes. So we got some copper A, some metal B and A. Oh, we got camp bonus. Ah, yeah. Yvonne got four arms merits. Zeri got four. Okay, actually, I've got 5, 4, and then 3 for helmet. Yeah, that's where... It's not so much leveling. Like, you still level up the classes. It's like, if you want to, like, go on the branching paths of upgrades, like, I think scouts can become a... Like, there's a different... Basically, it's a branch off to be one side is a sniper, and then, like, the other is, I think, just a super scout, basically. After completing a mission, you'll find yourself back in Yvonne's room. Here you can sleep until the next day, when new events and missions may become available. You can also view your battle stats and profiles of people you met. Useful information will be in class notes. You can visit at any time while at the academy, so you don't need to wait until after a mission. New options will be added here as you progress through the game, so it pays to come back and take a look every now and then. It's like we ran around and shot people with paintball guns in the face! Probably not paintball gun, probably rubber... Might just be rubber bullets.
To begin, here is today's news.
The drill grounds are now available. The R&D building is now available. Avon's room is now available. And daily life is added to the yearbook. Two facilities in the academy mode where you can use the funds and experience you've earned your group or squad. The first is the drill grounds. In the drill grounds, you can use experience points to raise soldier class levels. The second is the R&D building. The R&D building, you can use funds to improve your squad's equipment. Go visit other facilities before heading to the briefing room. R&D burden.
Yo!
There's something I wanted to run you through. At the R&D building, you can use funds you've earned during missions to develop and enhance your armaments. Once you've developed basic armaments such as rifles, machine guns, and armor, enough are produced for your entire squad. Come and gear up before a mission, or when you've earned more funds after completing a mission. You follow that? Try not to forget, yeah?
Welcome to R&D, kid. Make yourself at home.
Well, right now, it's just... Yeah. She is basically your vehicle pilot. Or she becomes Class G's vehicle pilot. Alright, let's develop warper. Need some riffles. Got riffles a lot. There's the Galleon 1. Not a huge increase. Bit better rumor. Oh yeah, I think the... Yeah, I think it's the... I think the engineers in this one actually just use big-ass fucking pistols. Yeah, the engineers actually just use... They changed it so the engineers actually use pistols in this. Some ace named Cindy and shoot her in the face. We can make super weapons. Lost all my mad ducats.
Listen up!
Alright, maggots, listen up! At the drill grounds, guess what? Use experience. All soldiers of a class gain levels at the same time, so there's no risk of anyone falling behind if they aren't deployed. Avon can also change to a class other than a scout with change class. If you're short on a certain class, Avon can change over to bolster your strength in that area. Got it! If I see any screw-ups, it's 100 laps! So, bitch.
Good! You're here!
No such thing as too much training. Oh, it just goes boop boop. Well, we're gonna need some scouts.
You've done well, man. That's another level.
I mean, I'm gonna work on leveling up everybody. But that's gonna be grinding, and that's gonna be off camera. So for now, we're just gonna get some scouty scouts. Because early on, you can still basically scout cheese. Later on, from what I remember, not so much, because this game isn't so much like the first one where it's just your fight, where it's just like, oh look, it's an enemy tank, boom. Oh look, it's an enemy tank, boom. Oh look, it's just a bunch of random dudes. No, there's a few things beyond just, you know, random dudes, the occasional big-titted plot device with a magic weapon.
Ah, Avon, how can I help you today?
Well, we got a new mission for Bruno. Maneuvering exercise. This exercise will teach you how to make use of terrain. Capture the enemy base camp using the terrain to your advantage. Aha! Alright, so we got Avon. Let's take helmet and lot and see how this goes.
Welcome to the ghetto.
Doesn't look like there's an enemy camp around to take advantage, or to basically leapfrog.
Time to show them what Class G can really do!
Alright, so we can't... Oh, I see there are air towers.
Underway.
Listen up!
Clean out those ears and listen up, maggots! Interception line of sight. Enemies will attack with interception fire when you approach them in action mode. It is dangerous to continue and move out in the open while under fire. Crouch behind sandbags or other cover, or end your action and move other units in for support. Watch the line of sight that appear when you identify interception fire swiftly. The sight lines appear when you see an enemy. While moving, take note of the direction and color of the line. Remember, you're half colors, colorblind man. Remember to keep an eye out for the line of sight when you're moving. So, okay. Simple as that! You better practice it before it goes out the other ear. Grassy areas. You can use grassy areas on the battlefield to move without being detected by enemies. Move one of your units into a grassy area and press up on the crawl. Unit will lie prone and continue by the grass. Concealed units cannot be seen by the enemy, so any sight lines will change to blue. Because concealed units will not be fired upon, it's a good way to bypass enemies or sneak up from behind. Enemies will still be able to detect you if you get too close, though, and then your units don't want to be concealed. Scouts are particularly good at spotting concealed enemies at long distance. Be on the lookout for enemy scouts when moving a concealed unit.
Enemy sighted. You're in the way. Target destroyed.
Great!
Supporting fire.
All right!
Landmines! Sometimes you come across landmines planted on the battlefield. Landmines are traps that are triggered when a unit steps on them and explode as soon as that unit tries to move away. You just found a landmine, do your best to stay away from it. If you have an armored tech nearby, you can disarm landmines by moving the armored tech up and pressing circle. If you step on a mine, remember that it will not detonate until you move away. Send an armored tech to disarm it. There are small and large versions of the landmine. The smaller mines inflict high damage on infantry, but less on vehicles. Large landmines do heavy damage to both infantry and vehicles, so be careful if you come across them.
Underway. There you are.
Thank you. coming at you. I see one. Enemy spotted.
Underway. I don't miss. Target destroyed.
Uh-oh. Well, Lenny. I thought I could make it. Hi. Next. What? Go next? Come on, guys.
Come in, yeah.
Roger. Enemy sighted.
Watchtowers and ladders. You can use watchtowers and ladders you come across in the battlefield to climb to higher positions. Watchtower here in the drill grounds. So try sending a unit to climb up one. Blah, blah, blah. When you attack enemies from a higher position, you receive a damage bonus because of the height difference. If you see a watchtower or a ladder in command mode, make sure to take advantage of it. It may even give you an opportunity to attack enemies that were hidden beyond the terrain, or behind terrain.
Target destroyed.
Oh yeah, I just gotta capture the shit, don't I?
Okay, let's go! Let me at him!
Hey,
coming at you! Enemy down!
We killed all the dudes! All the dudes!
Yes! We took their base camp!
Hey, we got some oak, some plywood, lead. Yay, we completed January.
To begin, here is today's news.
Set potentials at briefing room. New mission has been assigned. Miraculous! Story missions. Story missions are assigned after you complete a certain number of key missions. However, you must first view events marked with double exclamation marks to be able to accept them so you're fully aware of the background. If you're unable to accept the mission, it's likely because there is an event that you haven't seen yet. When story missions become available, there will always be events marked BRINK to view, so seek them out.
Listen up now.
Today we'll be covering the military history of ancient Europa. Barf. History's like my worst subject. Don't be so modest, Avon. I'm sure you're equally bad at all of them.
Hey, shut up!
Hey!
Avon, you dropped this photo. Oh, man. Thanks for catching that. It's a fall out of my notebook.
Is that your brother?
Yep, that's for Big Bro Leon. He's amazing at everything. He's totally my hero. I mean, he's strong, super dependable, and smart, too. And he's like the nicest...
Huh.
Pipe down. Class is about to start. Thank you. Now, everyone, open your books to page 25, please. What's going on? It sounds like... Lunchtime!
No.
What? Not again.
What the? You heard the bells.
Those bells mean you've been summoned to battle.
What? Us?
If I were you, I'd start getting ready.
Report of rebel aggression in the Arlem region has come in. Valencia Royal Military Academy is responsible for policing Southern Gallia. It falls on us to address any threats that arise in our jurisdiction.
What?
But wait, you can't mean that. Are you saying the weak decks are expected to fight unassisted? That is correct.
What? But that's... We're not...
Listen up now.
2 years after peace with the Empire, Gallia's defenses are still ragged. The militia can only be summoned against invasion. This is internal. That leaves you cadets, the creme de la creme of Gallia's youth.
But...
War is not so kind as to spare those in no will to fight. I guess there's no getting around it. Meet me in the briefing room as soon as you're prepared to leave.
Ready, then. As class chair, command in the field falls to you, Avon.
Right. I gotcha.
Your mission today is to drive the rebels back out of the Arlem region. Intel from our Vanguard unit reports a tank within the enemy squad.
They've got a tank! What do you expect a pack of foot soldiers to do?
I expect you to win. Thinking of how to go about that is your job.
That's easy for you to say. Their lives are all hanging on this.
Such is the nature of war. The exact same applies to the rebels as well. If you don't wipe them out, they'll gladly see you dead.
You act like it's easy. Fine. I'll get us through this without a scratch.
I look forward to it. Lanseal's bell has tolled. Squad G, move out!
We're deploying over together!
Here, bring him down!
Just because they're Darksons.
Hey! We've got an incoming rebel squad!
We'll never make it against a group that big! We're all gonna die!
Okay, everybody calm down! We'll all be fine. It'll work out, don't worry!
It'll work out? How can you say that with no grounds to back it up?
Hey, I've got grounds. The most violent waves lay bare a man's worth the fastest. Those are my brother's words. Now listen good. You give up, and it's over. And if I know anything, it's that we weren't meant to die here today. That means we can't give up, which means we fight. Those are my grounds.
You're right. Right, everybody? We can do this together! It's like Avon says, so long as we don't give up, there's still hope. Combat is scary, but we all have to do our part for any of us to survive.
I'm with you. I'm not ready to end it here. I'll fight.
Just how exactly is that speech supposed to get us through this alive? An appeal to emotion and some circular reasoning? You've got to be kidding.
So what? You have a better plan, dude?
Look there. The rebels only have a single tank. That's probably at the top of their chain of command issuing orders. Destroy that tank, and you behead the squad.
But how?
There.
That's a Ragnite container.
Right. I saw several of them littered about the area. Fueling stations for the villagers' farm equipment, I'd wager. If we lure the tank near those containers, then set them off with gunfire.
That's perfect! We can use the blast to take out the tank!
Sari, you're a genius!
Observation and logic will always yield a solution. Those are my grounds.
Okay, guys, let's get to work clearing those rebels out of here.
Listen up now.
Are you all listening? Don't forget what I'm about to tell you. Your squad members may awaken new battle potentials during your mission. Battle potentials are retained even when a unit changes class, as long as they're equipped. You can change the potentials you have equipped by selecting Change Potential at the briefing room. Let your squad members experience a variety of classes so they can awaken more of their inner potential. Did you get all that? There are no stupid questions, class. There's plenty of stupid questions. That's the story mission. Although we can go to the Brill Ground skirmish. I ain't going out on a mission till I save my game, motherfucker. Alright, everybody.
How can I help you today?
The bell has tolled. We need to go save. Let's go have a skirmish first. Get your paintball guns out, folks. We're gonna go shoot our classmates in the balls. A mock battle will be held at the drill grounds. Defeat all enemy units in each area. Alrighty then. I mean, we can call in more if need be. Come on, you Nazi bastard.
Let's do some damage, guys! Moving out! Coming at ya! Enemy down!
Underway. I'll show you what a man of the Empire can do.
I got your back.
Good.
Okay, let's go! Let me at him!
I'll assist.
What's a little blood loss?
Roger. I don't miss. Target destroyed. Enemy sighted.
Whoa. I think I found a landmine.
Takes more than that.
Hey, boo. Crap.
Coming at you!
As you command, leave watching our backs to me.
Wait.
You're in the way.
Oh, they changed it so that not anybody gets Ragnade in this. Not everybody. Okay. So only the engineers get the Healy stuff. This might suck.
Okay, let's go!
Wait a second. I have to kill everybody.
Underway. I'm afraid I cannot allow you to live.
I forgot this is kill everybody in.
Enemy silent! Enemy sighted! I'm in top form! Watch and learn.
There is a grenade here. Ah!
Enemy silent!
Thank you.
Cool, dude!
Where are you, Frenny? Yeah, dude. I could have put him on standby.
Watch and learn.
You're through!
Watch and learn.
Shock people.
Nothing to get riled about.
You're through.
Watch and learn.
Probably more people hiding in the grass. What?
Okay, let's go. I see one.
Sneaky, sneaky.
All right, we got the target.
Man. kind of crap, because you need to know exactly where those fuckers are.
To begin, here is today's news.
Nobody gives a fuck.
I've been waiting!
Pretty sure you get something at like...
You've done well, man! That's another level!
Pretty sure you get something at like 5. What does it change? Just likes class G. Yeah. Scout veteran. Scout capable of traveling long distances with other abilities upgraded as well. Or sniper mobility, HP, or yeah, so you either lose 200 AP or you gain 100 AP. Your accuracy does go up though. I think it's trooper veteran or gunner. Armed with Gatling that sprays a swath of bullets, or physical attributes also outshines shock troopers. So their accuracy goes to shit, but they get a Gatling gun. And then this, either a Lancer veteran, or you can get a mortar that works on people better. Engineer, either be an engineer veteran or Anthem Corps. There is an instrument that motivates allies to perform beyond their abilities, best used before an attack, and then that goes into some other shit. Tech. Unable to, strong defense, withstand direct gunfire, the only class that includes landmines. Fencer, unable to use guns, but can send flows flying with sword attacks. So they actually... They drop the wrench and take a sword, but they lose movement. I don't think I got enough money to...
Welcome to R&D, kid. Make yourself at home.
Submachine gun stuff upgrade. There's pistols to upgrade. But I'm too broke to upgrade. No blast suits. There's field. No combat suits, but there's field. Basically, field suits and pistols available. Well, anyway. We don't exactly have enough time to do a full mission before, without going too much overtime. So I'm just going to cut it here, and I'll catch you guys later. Adios.